Let us try to understand how interest payment calculation is done in the case of home loan for under construction property. In case of under construction property, the builder demands a cost in certain installments. And as per their raised demand, bank releases the amount directly to them. So let's start. Let us take an example. Home loan amount is just rupees 12 lakhs. Tenure is 20 years and interest rate is 8%. Your EMI will come around 10,000 rupees. So these are the figures we consider to understand the concept. You just have to concentrate on the highlighted rows in yellow color. The loan sanctioned on 1st January. The loan started on 1st January. The sanctioned loan amount was of rupees 12 lakhs. But on 1st January, only 1 lakh was paid to the builder. Why? Because builder demanded only 1 lakh in January. Rest 11 lakhs, bank will pay to the builder as and when the builder raises demand. On 1st January, 1 lakh was paid to the builder and also at the same time, 10,000 was deducted from your savings account as the first EMI. So, what is the balance? It is 90,000 rupees. You took 1 lakh from the bank and paid 10,000 back to the bank. So, the balance is 90,000. At the end of January, after 1 month, the bank will calculate the interest. The interest is calculated for 1 month duration. So, on 90,000 balance, the interest for 1 month at 8% per annum interest rate will come out as rupees 600. So, this 600 will get added to your balance. Your new balance is now 90,600 rupees. New month starts, February commences, second EMI will get deducted. Your balance reduces. Your new balance would be rupees 80,600. At the end of the month, again interest will be calculated on the balance in the same fashion and it will be added in your balance. Your balance now will be rupees 81,137. March starts, third EMI gets deducted. Balance reduces by 10,000. Again at the end of the month, interest for March month will be calculated and added to your balance. At the end of March, you have a liability of 71,612 rupees. Suppose on 1st April, builder raises a demand of 2 lakhs. You already paid 1 lakh in January and now additional 2 lakh is being paid to the builder. Bank directly transfers the amount to the builder and your balance gets increased by 2 lakhs as indicated. Also on 1st April, your first EMI gets deducted and accordingly the balance will get updated. At the end of the month, interest will be calculated on the balance and the same will be added to your balance. Month of May starts, your 5th EMI is deducted and your balance is updated. Now suppose in between you want to make a lump sum payment and reduce your loan liability. You can do the same. Suppose you arrange rupees 3 lakhs and deposit in your loan account. The balance would get updated accordingly. You can see the first time the balance has become positive from negative, which indicates you don't have any liability as of now, rather a surplus of rupees 46,644 rupees is available in your loan account. Since there was no liability as the balance was not negative, the interest will be nil for the month. June starts, the EMI will get deducted as decided, your balance will get updated accordingly. At the end of the June, again interest will be calculated, which will come out as nil in our case. So, this was just a basic illustration of how interest is calculated in case of home loan disbursed in installments. Hope you liked the video. Thank you for watching.